Oh, I'm the nostalgia critic. I remembered, so you don't have to. And with me still, and since I'm still celebrating Halloween of Horror, I figured since I just did a Stephen King double review, I should probably go and do a top five list for this month. So, what am I gonna do today? Well, how about the top five spookiest performances? Or no, spookiest wouldn't work. The top five scariest performances. There we go. That ought to work out well. So, let's get started with number five. Norman Bates. Boy, oh boy, what can I say about this guy? Well, he did a lot of horrible things, from killing Janet Leigh, who basically was like the first, was basically in there for like the first few minutes. And my God, the smile he gave, which of course I am showing in this picture, is friggin' terrifying. So yeah, it is a. He definitely deserves this spot at number five. Hannibal Lecter. Now, I'm gonna be honest with you guys. I never really found Hannibal Lecter in Silence of the Lambs that scary. I honestly thought the Buffalo Bill was a lot scarier because, well, he actually seemed like an actual serial killer. Hannibal Lecter to me always seemed like a James Bond villain. But in Red Dragon, well, I thought he was scarier because he actually wants to get Edward Norton's character. And of course, he's able, in fact, he even finds ways to get him from inside his cell. That is freaky as heck, or that's freaky as fuck. So yeah, you can lock him up and he can still get you. That is scary. And Anthony Hopkins definitely gave a scary performance in both movies. Ugh. The Gemini Killer from Exorcist 3. How to put this guy? He is terrifying, and after the death of Damien in the first movie, another demon known as the Gemini Killer came in and gave him a really, really terrifying performance. And all I have to say is, watch Exorcist 3 if you can buy the absurdity of it all. It's actually a really good film. I recommend it. Reagan from The Exorcist. My God, with this movie, it's said to be the scariest movie of all time. And while I don't fully agree with that, it is definitely a spooky film. Now, and Reagan definitely gave a really, really good performance in the movie. But just to make this thing even, okay, this little kid had everything. A spinning head, green vomit, and I guess she was also a murderer too, but I don't know how exactly that works. Is the idea that when the priest is found dead on the ground, was that meant to be a heart attack, or did Reagan kill him? If she killed him, well, how exactly did that work? I guess that is something to ponder. Anyway, on to number one. Because he's everything terrifying and scary about the evolution of man. Probably the biggest reason he's scary, well, we designed him that way. We have no one to blame but ourselves. And world. He's just, he's the ultimate computer. Has artificial intelligence. And when he sees the crew as a danger, they're gone. He destroys them. No second thoughts, he just destroys them. And he can play to our emotional side. However, with him, there is no emotional side. And he is probably the scary thing about technology. And the fact that we one day could create something like him is scary and sits in the back of my mind every day. He is the scariest thing I've ever seen, and basically the scariest performance. And given the fact that this movie, 2001: A Space Odyssey, was made in the 60s, and it is still scary even today, definitely said something. I'm the nostalgia critic I remembered, so you don't have to. And happy Halloween.
Boys and girls of every age, wouldn't you like to see something strange? Come with us and you will see the sound of Halloween. This is Halloween, this is Halloween. Pumpkins scream in the middle of night. This is Halloween, everybody make a scene. Trick or treat.